So today we will be discussing about the cryogenic vacuum pumps. Now basically, as I've already told you, I will quickly go through the cryogenic. Cryogenic, it's a science of maintaining or changing or having the temperature systems less than minus 150 or below the minus 150 degree centigrade. That is what we call it as the cryogenics. Okay, in order to create this cryogenics environment, the pumps are very much necessary. Say for example, we have already discussed the cryogenic liquids like nitrogen, liquid nitrogen, it may be argon or it may be helium or it may be neon, different types of cryogenics, even the oxygen, helium, everything is there. So different types of cryogenic fluids are there, and these cryogenics gases which has to be maintained in a condensed manner. That is, it should be maintained in a liquid state, because as the common sense, they say that a storing of any gases in the gaseous state doesn't give any meaning. Say for example, even if you have a deodorant which will be stored in a liquid state. Even your gases, methane gases or LPG gases, if you see the cylinder, the gases will be condensed, and the condensed liquid will be stored in the cylinders. And it will be stored under a very low temperature with a higher pressure. It has to be maintained a higher pressure than the surrounding pressure in order to make sure that the gas which is coming out of the cylinder should be able to evaporate and immediately convert that into the gaseous state. So in that context, to create such kind of, say for example, if you want to store a gas, store a deodorant in a deodorant bottle, the bottle should be made completely vacuum. Then you can store some gases in the form of liquid in that, and then you can use it further. This is the concept behind of it. Even if you take normal domestic purposes LPG gases, liquid petroleum gas, the cylinders will be emptied first. It will be made vacuum first, and then the LPG gases will be filled inside that at a very high pressure. The pressure may vary up to 100 or 120 or up to 200 psi. Say for example, if you take atmospheric pressure is 1 atmospheric pressure, and 200 atmospheric pressure will be maintained in the cylinder. That is the reason why immediately if you open the knob, it comes out and it will be converted into gas immediately. So that is the idea behind of it. In order to create these cylinders with a vacuum, the vacuum pumps are very much necessary. Now let us study how these vacuum pumps basically work. If you take what is a vacuum pump that operates by isolating volumes of gases, compressing the gas and exhausting to atmosphere. Obviously, it has got isolating the volume of gases. That means if you have 10 meter cubes of gases, it will isolate it and it will convert it into a liquid state. That is the first function of it. And the second one is, obviously, it will be compressed. Why it has to be compressed is a major area of interest over here. Now, you take a deodorant or you take an oxygen cylinder, or you take oxygen cylinder which we are using it in medical applications. Oxygen cylinder we are used in aerospace applications as an oxidizer. Liquid nitrogens are used, that is the nitrogen gases are used even in the applications of the industrial applications, or it may be used in the domestic applications, or it may be used in the metallurgical applications, even in the aerospace applications, or it may be hydrogen which is used in the aerospace applications, or liquid petroleum gases which are used in a domestic purposes. Irrespective of the application of the gases, it has to be stored in a liquid state. Is not enough, it should be stored in a liquid state with a higher compressive pressures. See my dear friends, you just imagine 200 atmospheric pressure into 1 atmospheric pressure, that is 1 atm to 200, that is only 200 times the pressure will be maintained. And the third one is to exhausting to atmosphere. That is what vacuum pumps that move gas through the interaction of high velocity particles or surfaces. That is what we call it as a diffusion pumps in the gravity, or we call it as molecular pumps. That is what we, that That is what the major applications of this vacuum pumps. In this scheme, gas molecules are removed from the gas phase by one of several techniques. That means in an empty cylinder, I cannot say it is an empty cylinder, my difference. When it comes to the cryogenics, I should say it will have some gases. A cylinder with gases, that is the atmospheric gas, can be removed from the gas phase by one of the several techniques. That means not only one technique, there are different techniques are there in order to remove these gas molecules. The gas capture may be accomplished by solidifying the gas on extremely cold surfaces. This is one of the wonderful procedure. The gas capture may be accomplished by solidifying the gas on extremely cold. That means the gas which is present in the cylinders or any space, it can be removed by exposing it to extreme cold surfaces. Say for example, if you have a spoon which is of extremely cold, will be subjected to the normal atmospheric air. Then what happens? The air which is at the atmospheric temperature and this extremely cold surface, what it will do it? It just absorbs the heat from that and attracts it towards a very cold surface. This is the basic physics behind of it. This form of gas capture is called as a cryocondensation. Now you can say, what is the degree of the cold surface temperature? Now when I say this procedure or this physics is being carried out under the cryocondensation, that means obviously the temperature must be less than minus 180 or minus 200 degree centigrade. Some gases such as helium, neon and hydrogen have such low boiling points that they are not readily condensed. Now, to be frank, the nitrogen and the argon are the two gases which readily condense. To be frank, the gases, I repeat, the nitrogen and the argon gases which readily condenses, whereas such gases like helium, neon, that is He, H2 and the Ne, the gases which have such a low boiling point that they are not readily condensed. It is very difficult for these gases to get condensed very readily. So that is the one point to be noted. So pumping of these gases may be accomplished by adsorption if through a series of collisions with cooled surfaces. Now, first and foremost thing is I just wanted to tell you what do you mean by adsorption. Adsorption is a procedure or it is a physics behind of attracting the molecules towards one surface, whether the surface is electrically charged or the surface may be a very cold temperature or the surface may be of any other way by which it will get attract the molecules, even in electrostatic like electrolytic attraction forces, where the positive and negative terminals will get attract the atoms from the positive anions. That is also comes under the category of adsorption. Now, if through a series of collisions with the cooled surfaces, a helium atom loses the kinetic energy, it may become adsorbed on this surface. Now, here is one wonderful application, apart from the electrical or magnetic or other source of adsorption, here is one of that type of adsorption. A series of collisions with the cooled surface, for example, if you have a helium atom which will be moving, helium, we know it is very fast moving, it will have a highest turbulent kinetic energy with which the molecules or the atoms will be moving around. The helium atoms which will be moving with the highest turbulent kinetic energy, these turbulent, highest turbulent kinetic energy of this atom will come across us with a collision with cooled surfaces, and these surfaces will reduce its kinetic energy. Once if one helium atom which is moving with the highest turbulent kinetic energy hits the cold surface, it loses its part of kinetic energy. Once again, if it goes and collides with the cold surface, it loses a little more kinetic energy. So ultimately, it will get adsorbed onto the surface. This is the actual physics of it. So in this state, the helium gas molecule is weakly attached to the cold surface and is for all purposes removed from the gas phase. Now, my dear friends, once these adsorbed helium molecules which will be attached to this cold surface will be weakly attached, and for all the purposes and most of all purposes what we do it is we remove the gas phase of this helium gases. One other difference between a gas capture pumps and the positive displacement or momentum transfer pumps is that the major difference what I'm just talking about is the gas capture pumps have a finite capacity. Once they are full, pumping action will cease until the pumping media can be renewed or regenerated. The major difference between gas capture pumps and the positive displacement pumps. These positive displacement pumps or momentum transfer pumps are same, which you have already discussed, which you have already studied in your turbo machines, if I'm not wrong. In the first module of a turbo machines, we always discuss about what is the difference between turbo machines and a positive displacement machines. You have come across with these positive displacement machines. How this positive displacement machine is unique from gas capture pumps is that once they are full, pumping action will cease. That is the major actually. Gas captures the pumps have a finite capacity. They will have a finite capacity, that is limited capacity to have. Once it has been full, you cannot go for further pumping. Further pumping may lead to cease the pumping media, and it can be reverted back only after regeneration. This is the major drawback of this. For this reason, the gas capture pumps are seldom used on vacuum systems which are designed for continuous high gas throughout. That is the major drawback of this gas capture pumps. This fact has an associated safety issue. Gas capture pumps collect and concentrate all the gas species they have pumped during their service time. This may be a drawback, and the industrialists should say that this will be a safety issue also, because once it gets easier, it will not operate it. If you just allow it to operate it, there may be some hazardous accidents may come across. That is why they say it as a safety issue also. If the pumping media is to be regenerated for further pumping, considerable care should be taken to carefully exhaust the gases which will be released from the pump during regeneration. That means if you want to regenerate the pumping media, in order to continue the process, enough care should be taken. That means the gases which are already got seized inside the pump has to be released carefully during the regeneration. That enough care should be taken. Okay. Now, the effect of temperature on the vapor pressure of gases. Now you can see it here. The gas molecules upon collision with cool surfaces lose a significant amount of their thermal energy to the cooled surface. Now, as I was just asking you good example, if you see a small burst or a ice cubes, or it may be an ice cream, if you take it out from normal refrigerator, I'm not talking about a normal refrigerator, a freezing chamber. From a freezing chamber, if you just take it outside, you can see a sort of fumes going out of this freezed material. That means a sort of fumes, like as the combustion takes place, you can see the fumes, right? So similar sort of fumes, you can observe it, any material, if you're taking it out from the freezed surfaces. So what is it happening actually?
ಹಲೋ ರವೀಣ.
ಏ ಅದ ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋರು ಎಲ್ರೂ.
ಏ ತಡೆ
This, I was just talking about the gas molecules, that means any freezed item which has been taken out from the freezer, you'll find a sort of fumes which are just coming out of it. That means the freezed item may be maintained around minus 100 degrees centigrade or minus 50 degrees centigrade, or it may be much lower than that. The gases which are surrounded by that will be of atmospheric temperature, maybe around 20 degrees centigrade. 20 degrees centigrade is a very huge temperature when it is compared with minus 100 degrees centigrade or minus 180 degrees centigrade. So when these gases, which are higher thermal kinetic, it will have a higher turbulent kinetic energy, and it will also be possessing with a higher thermal energy. When it comes and collides with this cold surfaces, it loses a part of its kinetic energy and also a part of thermal energy. That is what, once in general, it may be said that the thermal energy of a gas molecule is determined almost entirely by the temperature of the last surface the gas molecule absorbed from. Okay, if a surface is intentionally cooled to the temperature of liquid nitrogen, that means the liquid nitrogen will be cooled at 77 degree kelvins, or we can say it as a minus 196 degrees centigrade. See my difference, our atmospheric temperature may be from 22 up to 38 degrees centigrade. It will be varying, whereas this liquid nitrogen has to be maintained at a low temperature as minus 196 degrees centigrade. In such kind of cases, this vacuum pumps plays a significant role. All gas molecules which have a boiling point higher than minus 196 degrees centigrade can be cryocondensed on this surface. That means, if you want any gases more than, which are having a boiling point higher than minus 196 degrees centigrade, say for example, this can be illustrated with a surface over here. Now this surface, which has been maintained at minus 196 degrees centigrade, and this temperature has been maintained by using a liquid nitrogen, for example, and this cryo, the gases, atmospheric gases, maybe all these white balls, what you can see it here, assumed to be a molecules of the gas phases of different gases, whose boiling temperature is more than minus 196 degrees centigrade, will be subjected to or will be exposed to a surface which is of minus 196 degrees centigrade. Once these molecules come and touch with these surfaces, will get condensed, and these will be of similarly a thermal equilibrium of minus 196 degrees centigrade. That is what we are just intend to help out here. That is, these gases molecules will literally freeze, transforming from a gas to a solid. As solid material, these condensed gases are captured and eliminated from the gas load inside the vacuum vessel. Now, in light of this, I have given a liquefied gas cryogenic pumps. Cryo panels installed in a diffusion pumped vacuum vessels. Now here, as you can see it here, my dear friends, these two are the, what you can see it here, it is something like a cylindrical one, it will be like a cylindrical pump. Now these two, which will be of the inner surface, which we call it as a cryo panels. These cryo panels, which will be made up of, which will be made up of a gap, wherein which the facility will be, it will facilitate the flow of liquid nitrogen inside it, where the liquid nitrogen will have a minus 196 degrees centigrade, my dear friends. Now in this, what we will do it, we will allow the gases, the which gas, maybe around hydrogen, or it may be an argon, or whatever it may be, a different gas whose boiling temperature is minus more than minus 196 degrees centigrade is been allowed inside this vacuum vessel. Once this gas comes in inside this vacuum vessel, the gases which will be moving around, when it is moving around with some kinetic energy, when it touches the surfaces of this, it will loses its thermal energy and it will loses also its kinetic energy. So it will be get absorbed and get condensed. So this condensate will be taken out with the output outlet channel. So this is a one of the method for creating or liquefying a gas. This is how the cryogenic vacuum pumps are being used. So in the next class we shall discuss about the theory of compressed helium cryogenic pumps. Thank you.